Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Jacob, and today I just want to give you a little sneak peek on my latest Patreon kind of development. As some of you have maybe seen, I made this lovely scene with this super detailed candle. And in my latest Patreon video, I generally completed the whole candle. Next part will be that lovely interior scene that you've seen. So I made this kind of cutout studio scene where I pretty much explained all the logics of exposure, setting up lights, setting up studio lights. I'm also explaining how I generally modeled this whole label using just general modeling and Photoshop to get all these details to be nicely pronounced along with all the little micro bumps, etc. And now I'm going to give you a little sneak peek of some of the chunks from the video just so you can kind of get the feeling what it's all about. Let me just duplicate that. I'm going to duplicate it one more time and let me just collapse this. And now I got to this. So you see what is happening. So now when you look at, for example, this bottom part, you can feel how the blur is going from here all the way roughly up to here. Okay, for the millimeters, and I'm gonna go with 110, let's say. So whenever you are kind of shooting smaller objects, you can go with like super large millimeters, because the higher the millimeters, the more accurate the object is going to look like. It's going to have less distortion. I remember there was this one rule in this old photography studio that I was working for. They always shot small objects with like 120 millimeters. If you're shooting something that's super large, now we can actually start playing with the material. The reason why that 220 here is important is if you add, let's say, a white material, you know, a 220 white material, if your exposure is correct, you're going to see actual 220. If you're overexposed, you're going to see a higher number. So with this, you're kind of keeping the consistency of all the textures and everything. Okay, so let me just find my gold material. Let me just zoom in onto something like this. Okay, so I think I'm just gonna use the procedural noises for max. So let me just plug that into the bump. Yeah, let's make that size a very small blur, 0.01, of course. So, okay, we got this. One thing that I noticed also is you have a lot of these kind of micro bumps, and then you kind of have like these larger chunks everywhere. And generally, that's it. Well, hope to see you on Patreon. Take care. Bye.